I am pleased at this time to introduce a good brother who became a Teamster in 1969 and worked his way up through the ranks of the leadership of the IBT, being elected to an IBT vice presidency in 1998. In March of 2005, he was appointed as the director of the newly formed IBT Rail Conference, of which the BLET is a founding member. And in November 2006, he was re-elected as vice president for the Eastern Region of the IBT. Please join me in welcoming Brother John Murphy.
Good morning, everyone. You know, when I left the East Coast yesterday, it was raining and a little bit cool, and I was looking forward to the hot weather out here in Nevada, and I got off the plane, and I'm not sure what happened, but I think that the discourse here in this hall over the next few days is going to keep everybody warm and excited. I want to thank your President Dennis Pierce and members of the National Advisory Board for inviting me here today to introduce the leader of our great international union. Over the last decade, his leadership has transformed the Teamsters Union. He established for the first time in our union's history a dedicated strike fund. Under Jim's leadership, he created one of the most innovative organizing departments in all of organized labor. During his 11 years of service as our president, he is by far created, by even the most critics' view, one of the most effective lobbying programs in Washington, D.C. In the good times and in the bad times, his leadership has held our union together and steered us in the right direction. Over the last 2 years have been a very trying time for one part of our union. You may have read in the newspapers about our unionized freight industry is declining as the economy collapsed. He has worked tirelessly. I have personally watched him work day and night, weekends, trying to do everything that he possibly can to save one of our largest trucking firms, Yellow Roadway. Through his efforts and his team, we have kept that company afloat and have preserved the jobs of more than 20,000 Teamster members. All of this is an example of the kind of leadership that he has brought to the Teamsters Union. Brothers and sisters, I am privileged and proud to introduce one of America's greatest labor leaders, your national president, James P. Hoffa.
Thank you all. Have a seat. Great to see you. What a great time it is to be here. I had a chance to meet many of you last night at the reception. It's great to be here. It's great to see the face of a great union, to see the history that you have, and to visit with you as I look out on you. I see the face of the Teamsters Union. I see the face of the BLET. But most importantly, I see the face of America. You are America. You're the ones that keep America together. You are the great base. All the Teamster workers today, we are the base of America, and we should never forget that. It's a great pleasure, and I want to thank your President, Dennis Pierce, for inviting me here, a chance to visit with you and give you some ideas. He's taken over at a very, very difficult time in your union, and I think he's done a good job of the transition, and he's passed it on. He's doing a good job. You know, the BLET is the oldest union in America. And you know, it's also a union that has been innovative, a union that's been growing. When you merged with us in 2004, it was something special, along with the Brotherhood of Maintenance of Way. Because we have a vision of a great transportation union, one that covers road, rail, and the skies. And we are organizing and growing in every area. But most importantly, today, we talk about what that merger has meant for you and for us. It's meant so much. And today, the BLET is stronger because of that merger. We are strong together. We are marching into the future. We are together. And you know, this is politics time. You talk about politics, you talk about everything is interrelated. No matter what you do, you think, well, there's politics. I always tell this story about politics and how people should be registered to vote and participate. I love to tell this story about a Teamster, made about $150,000 a year, big-time truck driver, and knew everything. And I was talking to him about voting in the election. I said, we got to get together, we got to go out, we got to vote, we got to make sure we put our people in that believe in what we believe in. And he said, oh, I'm not registered to vote. I said, what? He said, well, you see, I don't want to do jury duty. That's why I don't register. Honest to God, that's a true story about one of our brothers. Hopefully I straightened him out, which I jumped all over his rear end. But I'm saying that's the kind of apathy we're talking about. But that's not true in this room. You talk about you here involved. And one of the issues we're talking about is how things are changing. The high-speed rail issue is probably one of the most important things that's happened in recent times. And you know, the Barack Obama administration, it's no surprise, we were the first major union to back him in February of 08. We got with him and we have told him we have to have jobs in America. And now we've got $8 billion to rebuild our rail systems. That affects everybody in this room. And we can do it. And thank God we got him in the White House. That wouldn't have happened with George Bush. I don't know if you know that or not. I'm telling you, we've got to have new locomotives. We've got to have new rails. We've got to have new roadbeds. We've got to have new cars for our railroads. And you know what's important and what we tell Barack Obama and his administration and what Dennis tells everybody? That's a good idea, but make sure they're made in America by Americans so we can put people back to work. That's the issue. And that's the issue through all these things. It's about jobs. It's about America, how we rebuild America. That's what this is about. And the same thing with this green job issue. They talk about green jobs all the time. They talk about solar, the sun, the wind, the water, how we put that together, and how they're going to put these windmills that you see all around the country now. You know, that's a good idea, but again, make sure they're made in America and not in China or India or Mexico. That's what we're talking about. That's how we're going to put America back to work. This is not complicated. This is not complicated. But all those jobs that are gone, we've got to get them back. And it affects everybody in this room because that's part of what you do. So we've got to keep on this road of rebuilding and to make sure. But this $8 billion is so important to the BLET because what it means is help now, but help to the future. Help to those that follow you because this is an opportunity to rebuild our rail system, to have new jobs, and to make sure that your union is here another 100 years from now. It can do it, but we got to make sure that we keep making sure that we have more organizing and everything else. Also, we changed the law at the National Mediation Board. So if you do organize, you can go out and organize now. And the law used to be since 1930 that when you had a vote, you had to get everybody that was eligible to vote, had to vote first before you even won a majority. So if there were 1,000 people, you had to have all 500 people vote, 51%. That's not fair, because half the time people don't vote, and somebody that doesn't vote counts against you. We changed that along with Dennis Pierce, and we went and talked to the mediation board, and today it's a simple majority. So now the BLE can go out and organize and grow, and that's important. That's another victory that we have with the Obama administration. Let me tell you a little bit about what we've been doing in the Teamsters Union, because we've been out organizing too. As we talk about air and we talk about rail and we talk about road, to be the largest transportation union in America, we've been out organizing. In the past, we've organized more than 80,000 people in the past 2 years. And we've done that by organizing 12,000 mechanics at United Airlines. That's the air. We've organized 8,000 ramp people at Continental. We've organized 20,000 public employees. We've organized 30,000 bus drivers. Everywhere we go, people want to be in this union. You hear these commentators say, oh, unions are a passe. Well, something's going on out there. We just organized another 1,100 people in Pasco County, Florida, yesterday. We got that results. So there's a lot of things going out there, but you have to go out and grasp it. In the Teamsters Union, we have a mighty army of organizers. And you know, we have to make sure that you're doing the same thing to go out as these new opportunities come up, so you're not going down, but you're going up. And I think that's the message that we have today. To keep our union strong, we have to grow. And we have to be big and strong at the same time, because that translates into power everywhere. Power at the ballot box and power in your union when you go to the bargaining table. And we've got to make sure that we're strong politically too. You know, we talk about these upcoming elections in November, and you talk about all the different things going on. It was kind of interesting last night. I was had my television on, and here being in Nevada, they had on ads for Senator Harry Reid. And they were talking to his opponent, which is a teabag woman. And she's a teabagger. And she was telling me how, and she was making in this ad, and it was an attack ad, how she believes we ought to get rid of Social Security. And we ought to get rid of the VA so the veterans don't get any benefits. He said, we ought to privatize all that. Well, next on that list is your railroad retirement. Do you want to get rid of that? Hell no. She'll give you an IRA is what she'll give you. Well, we're not going to let any of that happen, but it starts with you to be active politically. You know, a lot of people say, and I talk to people all the time, well, I'm not political. I don't get involved, and I probably don't vote. Well, it's important to vote, because what we're doing now with the $8 billion, what we're doing now with making sure America's on the right track, making sure we have jobs, to making sure we can organize, that's all tied to politics. If we get the wrong people in the White House and the wrong people in the House and the Senate, they're going to roll back the clock. They're going to change everything that we've worked for. They're going to make sure you don't get the $8 billion. And they're going to make sure they roll this clock back to about 1900, because that's where their heads are at. We've got a lot of work to do here in this country. And being politically active is so important to everything we do. We've got to go out and make sure everything is done right. And you know, we also talk about the fact that you have the Rail Advisory Board, which Dennis has set up, you know, within the Rail Conference. And that's an important part of what we're doing with the BLET, to make sure we can innovate and move forward with regard to ideas as to how we implement this $8 billion and how we make sure that it goes to the right spots when they spend that money, to make sure we get the bang for our buck, to make sure we start growing America on the rails anywhere else.